Hi, and welcome to this Phantasm tutorial. I'm Sebastian Bleek, and in this episode, I'll be taking you through how to easily create a basic halftone in Illustrator. Overall, we'll cover creating a basic halftone and editing your halftone. If you'd like to apply this as a permanent uneditable adjustment, just select your artwork, go into the object menu, scroll down to find filters, Phantasm, and then look for halftone. I'm going to hit escape. For this tutorial, I'm going to go into the effect menu, scroll down till I find Phantasm, and then choose halftone. Because I'm going into the effect menu, I'm actually applying this as a live effect, which means I'll be able to edit this in the future. Clicking on halftone brings up the halftone settings, and we already have our basic halftone. Now let's take a look at how to edit this halftone. Over here at the top, under type, by default it's set to monochrome. You have this drop-down menu, so you could choose different colors. You could go with RGB, or you could sample the image itself. I'm going to stick to monochrome. Over here, just to the right of monochrome, we have this color chip. When you click on it, it's going to bring up the color picker, which is going to allow you to choose a different color for your halftone. Next, we have pattern. By default, it's set to grid, but you also have FM and radial to choose from. Along with these in the drop-down menu, you have a little sub-menu here, so you can choose different behaviors for your patterns. Next, we have DPI, and this is going to determine the size of your dots. By default, it's set to 18, but if we reduce that number, notice my dots get larger. If I continue to reduce that number, the dots just get bigger and bigger. That means if I have a higher value in there, the dots are going to get much smaller. Next, we have grid angle. When you click on this, you have this little slider, or you could enter in a specific value. I'm going to go with 30, and when I tab over, notice we have a 30-degree angle here set to our grid. I'm going to leave it there with the basic settings. I'll click OK, and notice over here in the Appearance panel, we've applied that Phantasm halftone as a live effect. I could click on this link so I could edit this in the future. I'm going to deselect my artwork, and that's it for this tutorial. Overall, we've covered creating a basic halftone and editing your halftone. Make sure you watch the next episode in order to understand how to easily create a duotone effect in Illustrator. And don't forget, all of our plugins are available for a free trial at astutegraphics.com. Thanks for watching.